Hi everybody, my name is Bud Brown, and I thought I would just share with you a little bit about the Tagalog language. This is just an introduction, and I hope to have some more lessons. Even though I'm an American, I've spent some time in the Philippines. My wife is Filipina. We've been married 35 years, and so we talk in Tagalog and in English in the house. And a lot of Americans that have married Filipinas, or Americans that are just interested in the Philippines, have asked me if I could share some tips on learning Tagalog. So I just wanted to give you a short lesson right now, and then later we can follow with some other lessons. I want to just give the introductions, like you would say in Tagalog. I'm an American, or I am a Filipino, or I am French. You would say the nationality first, and then say ako, means I. For example, I would say Americano ako. My wife would say Filipina ako. If you're from France, Francesa ako. Germany, Aleman ako. Now, I should say right off the bat that Tagalog is not my first language, and if there's Tagalog speakers there that would disagree with anything I say, I'm sure you would be more correct than I am, and I don't mind being corrected myself, because I always want to learn more. So if there's something I'm saying in this lesson that doesn't make sense or it just isn't right, be sure and let me know in the comments, and I would appreciate that. Okay, so ako means I. The word for you is ikaw, ikaw. But if you're saying an expression, I would say, if I want to say, are you an American? Americano ka ba? This ba at the end of it is like a question. A little word means question. Americano ka ba? Filipino ka ba? Frances ka ba? Like that. Are you an American? Are you Filipino? Are you French? The word for yes is oo. Oo. There is a more respectful form, opo, or oho. The word for no is hindi, with a respectful form, hindi ho, hindi po, like that. If you add ho or po, then it makes it more respectful. If you want to ask someone where they're from, you would say taga, taga saan ka, means where are you from? Taga saan ka? And then you would answer with taga sa America ako, or taga sa Pilipinas ako, means I'm from America or I'm from the Philippines. Greetings, there's really not a hello, but you can say good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, and it sounds like this. Magandang umaga. Magandang umaga. Maganda means pretty, and umaga means morning. And a lot of words in Filipinos have a kind of an ang between the words, like this. Magandang umaga. Magandang umaga. Magandang hapon. Magandang gabi. Umaga is morning, hapon afternoon, gabi night. Magandang gabi. The word for hello, I mean for how are you, is como esta ka? Como esta ka? So, good morning, how are you, would be magandang umaga, como esta ka? A more polite way, or more formal way, como esta ho kayo? Kayo, although it means, it can mean you all, or plural of you, it also means a respectful you, meaning for one person. Like an older person, I would say, como esta ho kayo? Magandang umaga ho. Como esta ho kayo? And the answer is fine. Mabuti. Mabuti. a lot of the words in describing words in Tagalog, which we call grammatic and formal grammar, we call adjectives, start with ma. Not all of them, but a lot do. Like we've talked about, maganda is beautiful, which by the way you can say maganda ka, you're beautiful, maganda ka. But you're handsome doesn't start with ma. Guapo ka, you're handsome, guapo ka, maganda ka. But other words, describing words like maliit, small, malaki, big, malamig, cold, mainit, hot. So a lot of words that describe things are which are called adjectives begin with ma. So this will help you in kind of classifying different words in Tagalog. I think that's going to wrap it up for this lesson. The word for goodbye is paalam, paalam. Okay, goodbye. Till next time. Paalam.